Hello friends, welcome to our Dress My Craft YouTube channel. My name is Isha Tripathi and today I'm here to tell you about the difference between floral oriental and soft floral oriental paper collection. But before that, please subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell icon to get notified for our latest videos. Dress My Craft originally launched floral oriental collection for all the flower making lovers. And later they came up with soft floral oriental collection. So let me tell you about its features and difference between the two. These two paper collections are perfect for making flowers. So if you are a flower lover, then these are the must-have papers in your collection. Both the paper collection have 10 sheets each in its pack. Both are 12 by 12 inch in size. Both the paper collection are acid free. The only point of difference between these two paper collection is paper weight. The soft floral oriental paper collection weighs 120 gsm, whereas the floral oriental paper collection weighs 285 gsm. Now I'm going to make flower using Dress My Craft pointed daisy die using the soft floral oriental collection, and another flower using the Dress My Craft 6 petal flower die and floral oriental collection. So let's get started. To make the flower, I have already pre-cut the flower petal using the soft floral oriental collection, and I'm using the archival ink violet color to color my die cuts. You can use any color shade of your choice. Now you can see I'm not completely covering my die cut with ink. It's up to you how you want to color your flower petal. To shape the flower, I'm using the Dress My Craft Groove Golf tool set. These tools are made up of high quality stainless steel. I hope you can see these grooves on its head. These grooves on its head allow the flower bloom more naturally and beautifully. You can buy the Groove Golf tool individually as well as in set of 4. Now coming back to the flower, I am taking the flower die cut, dipping it in water for 5 to 6 seconds approximately, and I'm taking it out on a piece of paper towel to remove extra water if any. This process will make the flower petal more soft and pliable, meaning it won't have any crack. Since the soft floral oriental paper collection is soft already, therefore, you need not to put any extra pressure while shaping the flower. To make the flower center, I have taken small pointed styrofoam bud and I'm dipping it in Ultimate Craft glue. And with the help of my finger, I'm evenly spreading it out on the bud. Now, I'm dipping this bud in sparkling dust by Dress My Craft to finish the look of my flower center. Lastly, I will be heat setting the flower die cut to dry quickly, or you can let air dry naturally. It is absolutely your choice. Now with the help of my Groove Golf tool, I am poking hole in the center so that I can pass the styrofoam bud. I will add little extra glue in the center of my flower die cut or on the bud so that I can fix the bud in place. So here is the final look of my flower. Isn't it pretty? If you find this video interesting, do hit the like button. It really helps us in creating more fun videos for all of you. Now I've taken the bigger flower die cut and dipping it in water, and I'm removing the excess water with the help of my paper towel. I'm placing the flower die cut on the Dress My Craft embossing pad, and I'm taking the larger Groove Golf tool to shape my flower. You can clearly see I'm putting no extra pressure in shaping my flower petals, all cause of soft floral oriental paper collection. You can allow to dry the flower petal naturally, but here I'm taking my heat gun to dry the flower die cut. And with the help of my flower shaping tool, I'm cupping the center of my flower to give extra shape. With the help of my Groove Golf tool, I'm poking hole in the center so that I can insert my flower center. To make the flower center, I'm taking the mini white thread pollens from Dress My Craft and small pointed styrofoam bud. I will be putting some ultimate craft glue on my bud and press the thread pollens around it with the help of thread pollens around it. We'll be putting some more extra ultimate craft glue so that all the thread pollens adhere into its place. And with the help of my scissors, we'll be trimming down the excessive pollens from the bottom. Now our flower center is ready. It is time to put it in the flower. I will be inserting the flower center in the hole made with groove golf tool, since the pollen threads have made the bud little bulky, so it will be difficult to pass it through. I will be making slight cut in the center with the help of my scissors, so it will be easy to fix the flower center. Lastly, taking my Dress My Craft floral tape, I will be covering the wire to give a complete look to my flower. You can make 2-layer flowers, 3-layer flowers, it is absolutely your choice. I have gone ahead and created the rest of the flowers using the same technique as I have shared it with you. Lastly, I will be showing the smallest flower from the pointed daisy die set that we can use as fillers for our floral sprays or projects. I will be repeating the process of dipping the petal in water, removing excessive water with the help of paper towel, and lastly shaping the flower die cut with flower shaping tool. I will be cupping each petal and center of the flower die cut. With the help of my groove golf tool, I will be poking hole in the center, and lastly will be adding the drop shape wire pollen white in color as my flower center. To fix the drop shape wire pollen as the flower center, we'll be adding little ultimate craft glue in the center to fix the wire pollen. I will be repeating the same process for other small flower die cut. I will be mentioning the links down in the description box below for all the products. So here is the final look of a daisy flower using the Dress My Craft pointed daisy die set. This die set have 5 different shape of flowers. We made these gorgeous daisy flowers using the soft floral oriental paper collection. Now moving ahead with the floral oriental paper collection, we will be making the 6 petal flower by Dress My Craft. I have gone ahead and colored each flower die cut with forget-me-not archival ink and repeated the entire process that we did while creating daisy flower with soft floral oriental collection. Since we have shaped the flower petals using the groove golf tool, now we are simply cupping the flower center from the center with flower shaping tool. To make the flower center, I am using the small pointed styrofoam bud and micro mini pearl beads white in color. Firstly, I will be dipping the bud in ultimate craft glue, and with the help of my finger, I will be evenly spreading the glue on my bud. After that, I will be dipping the bud in micro mini pearl beads, tapping the extra off and gently pressing the bud with my fingers to shape the pearl beads. Now we'll be poking hole in the center of a flower petal and inserting the styrofoam bud and fixing it with the help of our ultimate craft glue. Now we will be shaping the bigger flower petal, and for its flower center, I have already gone ahead and did my styrofoam bud with micro mini pearl beads. For bigger flower, I have used bigger styrofoam bud in round shape. And lastly, putting some ultimate craft glue on the styrofoam bud, I'm fixing the flower center. For the smallest flower, I have used yellow drop shape wire pollen as my flower center. Isn't this flower looking super pretty and gorgeous? I hope I was able to tell you the difference between these two paper collections. Now we have created together the daisy flower using the pointed daisy die by Dress My Craft and soft floral oriental paper collection by Dress My Craft. And once these paper dry, the flower turn out to be super stiff and hard. The other flower that we created together was a 6 petal flower using the 6 petal die and floral oriental collection by Dress My Craft. I have created few more flower using the Dress My Craft floral dies. Here I have a 5 petal flower using the Dress My Craft 5 petal dies. And here is the another flower that I have created using the Dress My Craft 4 petal die. This is my personal favorite. I hope I was able to inspire you all with all these amazing creations. If you like the video, do hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon to stay updated with all the latest new releases and free tutorials from Dress My Craft. Till then, take care. Bye.